We went to 14 NFL cities and we're hoping to do at least that many, maybe more.
Okay.
So we're in partnership with the NFL and doing some character stuff.
Great. Thank you. Right. Well, it was great to meet you.
Nice meeting you. Okay, yeah. You're based here
in LA, yeah.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Anthony, nice to see you again. Ellie Segback. So first of all, big event today. For the last 8 years, Jim Moore is doing what he doesn't have to. He could just write a check, hands-on, helping kids who are sick. Tell me about why you're supporting him and what do you think about what he's doing?
Well, the reason I support is because it's impressive that individuals that have a platform like Coach Moore and a lot of other guys take the time to be engaged, to be involved, and to be there themselves. They understand the impact that you're more than just writing a check, but to be there and to have the personal impact. So that's what's impressive. Not only the fact that they're helping a lot of youth, but the fact that he's there. And again, when I was first invited and I saw what he was doing, that's the attraction. That's the reason why I want to support it.
You're a former athlete. You're very competitive. It's your nature. How are you in golf? What are you going to do on the course today?
Yeah.
Well, let's put it this way. On the football field, very, very competitive here. More competition with myself, so it's kind of a, you know, it is a very humbling game. You know, I played high school baseball in addition to football and college baseball. So the thing I'm trying to understand is how I could hit a 90-plus mile-an-hour fastball, and this ball that's just sitting there, not moving, is so difficult. But, you know, it's a challenge now. As I get older, there's fewer and fewer things that you can do physically, but golf is something that you can play for a lot of years. So it's very challenging. Every course I play is challenging, and I guess every time I get over the ball is challenging. But I love doing it.
These days you live in Cincinnati.
Yep.
A good friend of mine lives in Cincinnati. His name is Adrian Broner. Are you familiar with him, the boxer?
I'm a big boxing fan. I've not watched him fight. I got a couple buddies that are working with them, so yeah, I mean.
Mike Stafford?
I'm familiar with them, but like I said, I've not watched them fight.
Who are your favorite boxers? Because I mostly cover boxing.
Okay, well, I'm older. I'm a lot older.
Okay.
So let's go back to the division with Duran, Hearns, Hagler,
Leonard.
Sugar Ray. To me, that was one of the best of all times, not to mention, you know, of course, the greatest of all time.
Ali.
But, you know what, it's one of those things where I love the sport. You know, a lot of people love to see the first round knockout. I'm happy with, 10, 11 rounds of just strategic boxing, some really great strategy, some boxing, some offense, some defense. But I've been a big boxing fan for a long, long time.
That's great to hear. Mayweather's last fight against Maidana was very close. I don't know if you had a chance to see it, but what do you think about Floyd Mayweather?
Let's put it this way. I wish there would have been a Pacquiao-Mayweather fight. To me, that's all that matters with his career. I wish that would have taken place. Who knows? He might have, annihilated Pacquiao. But if they would have both fought, I think that would have been the true test. I mean, there's no question about it. Mayweather is amazing. I mean, now, 37, 38 to do what he's doing, it's just even more amazing. But for me, being the big boxing fan, it's hard for me to go through both their careers and say, without that fight having taken place.
Absolutely right. Now, people want to follow you. Are you on Twitter? You have a Facebook, a website?
I'm on Twitter at Anthony Munoz, HOF. Anthony Munoz Foundation is on Facebook. I'm not on Facebook. But, so I am on Twitter.
And we'll support your foundation. You're giving back. Cincinnati needs it.
Yeah.
It's a very rough city. For people who don't know, never been, it's a tough area. And
it is. And the Anthony Munoz Foundation, you go to munozfoundation.org. We do a lot of work there. But now my son and I are starting to do work nationally with the Munoz Agency. So, this has been a heartbeat of mine. So, the fact that I get a chance to do things like this, and then you see Coach Moore doing it, again, as I mentioned, this is why I'm here, to support what he's doing and really appreciate and applaud what he's doing.
There you have it. Thank you so much, Evan.
Take care.
Thanks. EsNews.com, Melly Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Segback.